All right, guys, what's going on? It's the third day of spring. We're here on the farm. And real quick, I want to tell you, oh, there he is. So we hired out this Field 62 work just because I didn't have time to get to it. So we have Farm Boy out here. I'm paying him $15,000 to do this whole entire field. Now, I'm still paying for like the seed and fertilizer and stuff. But yeah, so we're paying him 15K, which is kind of cool. Okay, he's on Randy's and Farm Boy's place. I'm not sure what that's all about, but I have been off recently, so it's I just haven't had much time. I've been kind of busy in real life. So cool. He's getting going there, and it looks like he just did the outer pass, and we're planting soybeans in this field. So cool, guys. We have a lot more coming, and excited to get this field done. And then tomorrow, the first day of summer, we will harvest these fields and then come and plant soybeans in that just right after that. So cool. It's awesome. We hired Farm Boy, our first hire. We paid him 15K. He pulled his truck up. He's like, sir, can I do this for you? I'm like, gosh, dang it. You're a true American right there. So we hired him, and things are going good. So the farm's awesome. And yeah, we have a bunch of seed in the back. All right, guys, next time I come here, this field will be planted. Gosh, every time, guys, Bolt is late to get to work here. Let me lay on the horn. I think he's sleeping in. Jiminy Christmas. We need to get to work. There he is. Come on, Bolt, get her started. We gotta get to work, man. There we go.
Sorry, it takes a while to start.
Yeah, no, that's all right. What were you doing? Were you sleeping again?
No.
Definitely not. He was, guys. But today it is the second day of summer. We are late. We should have been harvesting this winter wheat yesterday. Was the first day we should have harvested. It was perfect weather, but I couldn't. I had other stuff going on around the house. I was reseeding the lawn, so we got that, and the grass is growing quick. So we have everything ready. We are just getting to work. We got all the equipment ready last night. Literally just left it out, crashed, went to bed like at midnight, and then now it's now we slept in. So it's like, Bolt, stay out of the wheat, man. Come on.
I wasn't in the wheat.
Yeah, you. All right. It looked like he was a little bit, but it's, what is it? It's 1:30, about 1:30, and we are gonna get going here. We leased it, I guess. Yeah, we leased it. So, Bolt, show everybody the what we did to the truck, the new updates.
The top.
Yeah, show them the top. And we got a new tailgate, just because I didn't like that one. There it is, guys. Check it out. It's a rolling cover, so it's super clean, super nice. Cool, Bolt, man, love the truck. Hook it up to we'll have you. No, honestly, yeah, we don't even need it today. I was wrong. So I'm probably gonna run the combine. Bolt's gonna run the 6R. We're taking all this winter wheat, placing it directly into our bins, and we're gonna go for there. So the combine that we leased today, we're gonna try and only use it for like an hour. That's why I bought the huge header. This is I'm pretty sure it's a 45-foot. And it's 9650. It's the STS, and then I bought extensions on the top too. So we're gonna be able to hold a lot. Want to knock these fields out, be done. Our soybeans are growing good in field 62. I actually hired that out. I forgot to show you guys. I hired it out to Farm Boy. So Farm Boy, we paid him $15,000 one night to plant field 62, which I thought personally was worth it. So we're gonna get going here. Start up the old engine. We'll get her fired up. All right, so I should be able to fill up pretty quick with this big header. It's probably a hair too big for technically like for this combine, but it should be fine. And then directly when we get done, like literally, we will probably actually start planting before. We might actually need our 450 today. We might need the pickup truck, because we're probably going to be seeding once I get done with like these little fields and jump to the big one. We're probably gonna jump over and start seeding soybeans today, right when we get done planting, because we can and we need to. So we're gonna try and get our soybeans in, harvest them probably late winter, and then we're probably gonna try and do another winter wheat. We might do oats this time, just because I think oats are a little more profitable. But kind of looking at things in a finance perspective, it costs us about $25,000 to $30,000 to lease this equipment. Now I'm accounting for like how many hours we're gonna run it, and if we have this combine for more than an hour of running time, that's gonna be super expensive. So that's why I bought the big header. I want to knock this field out ASAP, and just be done with it, get out of here as soon as possible, in return this combine, because leasing ours is the most expensive. What, it was like $19,000 just to lease it, and then it's like $4,000 or $5,000 every single hour, so super expensive. And then we leased, I guess we haven't bought anything on the farm since we started, but one thing that we're thinking about buying is either a combine or some sort of seeder. So that's kind of what we're looking at, and we'll be trying to pay attention to the auctions. All right, guys, it's my turn to unload the grain cart. Things are going good. We have pretty much all the small ones knocked out here. I'll go into our map here. Let me pull up my phone. I'll show you guys what we have done so far. There we go. So we got these done, and then we have to knock out the big one and then like the little tiny one. So last time we made, I think it was just over $50,000 on the fields on like home base, or like the fields right by our house. And then from field, I think from field 62 alone, we made like $180,000 for that. That's for soybeans. So this year we should be more profitable planting soybeans in this area as well, and then also doing winter wheat. So we're gonna make a lot of money. And like I said, we aren't taking this to the sell point right now. I'll probably wait until pretty much just watch prices, and then we'll kind of do it all at once. And we don't need the money right now. Last time we didn't wait at all. We just went gung ho, sold it all right away, and that's because we needed money to pay our loan. So there we go. Got her unloaded. I'm gonna go bolt. Radio in. How full are you?
I'm 79%.
Okay, sounds good. I'll be over there in a second.
Got it.
All right, so we'll go find Bull. I think he's on this side. One thing I really love about our farm is that we have like two in and outs, or like two entrances, which really, really helps us like move around the farm. And like I can get to Bull pretty much anywhere. Obviously, he's got to like kind of come on the side a little bit, but I don't know. I feel like our farm's pretty good for... All right, there she is. We'll get her unloaded here real quick. And then I'm thinking I'm probably gonna, I'll probably hook up the pickup truck to this grain trailer, and then that way I can get seating. And now that bolt's kind of like, ooh, it is kind of tight with this. The header is just so big, and we could have bought we could have leased the combine with a bigger spout or a bigger pipe, but we, it was gonna cost like another, I want to say another grand to lease it, which is not worth it at all. And we aren't doing a lot. So it's all about speed on this one. Hopefully we can get this done in under an hour. We just need to keep going and keep hustling. One thing I forgot to show you guys is that we actually bought a maintenance shop. So now we can do maintenance on our vehicles and change things on the vehicles. So that's how we changed the cover and the tailgate and a few other things on the truck we added as well. So This was like $20,000. Okay, I guess that's something that we bought. Yeah. Eventually, we were going to need that because, like, say something. Well, eventually, we had to do maintenance on all the vehicles. So we have to have that. And there's no other place. There's no other one on the game. And I thought, you know what? Let's just buy it. Get it over with. We have the money right now. It's something we needed to get done. So the plan is I'm going to hook up. I'll have the grain trailer hooked up to the F450, and then I'll be seeding or planting our soybeans in the 6R. There we go. She's connected. And then Bolt will pretty much just run around here, unload from it, and we will be good to go. There we go. We're locked and loaded. We're full. I'm going to knock these first three fields out. There's Bolt. We can see him there. Cool, cool. So I think the crop is yielding a little better than last season, which I'm obviously super happy about. Let's try and get this over the ground before we get going. But yeah, things are going good. Like I said, I'm going to get these seeded. I wonder how many or how much seed we're going to run through. I kind of forgot what the numbers were last time and how many crates of fertilizer and pallets of seed we needed. But we have plenty in the barn, so I think we should be just fine. And there we go. We even have one on the side of the barn. Don't know how that got. Oh, wait, that's lime. We won't need lime. We will need lime after... Yeah, we'll probably spread lime either early spring or probably early spring, unless we plow before winter, which probably won't happen. But if we do, then we would plow, throw lime on, and then plant come springtime. But actually, I'm trying to think, we might need, I gotta remember. All right, guys, I'm finishing up these three fields by the house, and then I'll go. All right, I'm gonna finish these three fields up by the house, and then I'm gonna go down. And I think Bolt is chugging along really fast. Bolt, are you almost... Does the grain cart need unloaded?
Nope. It's nope. In the field right now.
Okay. Is it full though?
No. Halfway already. Okay. Empty at one.
Oh, gotcha. When you let me know when you empty, I'll do it. So that we don't waste any time in the combine. Here we go, boys. The beans are planted and we're getting going. So hopefully we get some rain here. Hopefully conditions are good and it's a good yield. I'm hoping rain's not too bad. And then I think I missed a little bit down there. I'll go hit that and then we'll check it on Bolt. All right, guys, so we got to unload Bolt and then I will take this. And I think this is going to be our third load. So when I look in the end, I'll see exactly how much we got from this in total in liters. So I can roughly gauge like what prices are right now to see how much we made off this and kind of compare it to last year. Here we go. We're getting unloaded. And yeah, I like the new truck. I like our cover. That works really good. And I just wanted to, the gooseneck tailgate was nice, but I just wanted to change it to the regular one because I think it looks better. And Bolt was giving me crap for it. So, Bolt, how's everything going?
Good. Just unloading.
Nice. So yeah, just finish this up. I'm going to go unload this and just holler at me when you're full again.
Got it.
Thanks, man. All right, there we go. And then another thing I was thinking about is probably once we're done planning here, we're gonna do maintenance on every single vehicle, everything that we own that can get maintenance. We'll probably do here just because we bought that shop and that's kind of what it's meant for. And that way during harvest time, like everything's running smoothly. Never want to break down during harvest. The last thing we would need. There we go. All right, we're starting on the big field, putting down soybeans, and the forecast looks really good too. So that's something that I was keeping an eye on is the forecast. Make sure that when we harvest here, because we have a really small window. I'll kind of show you guys here. I'll show you guys right now. Actually, here, let's look real quick. So we're planting soybeans. This is the last day to plant it. And then what? It's going to be probably the last day of fall that we're going to be able to harvest. Then we'll try and plant, get oats, barley, or wheats down like that day. So we could do canola, but we'll just stick to these three cereal crops. That'll be way easier. And then if we go to weather, there is rain. It looks like on Thursday, which is, I think Thursday would be the second day of fall. So hopefully it rains that second day of fall. And then the third day of fall, we're able to literally get all of our field work done because we'd be screwed. And we are kind of like, it's pretty risky what we're doing that we didn't plant this earlier because like it just all your days are kind of tightened up. And because we didn't plant this earlier, which we should have done yesterday. So that's kind of why maybe it's a little more risky than just normally plant. Because if it rains that whole day, we aren't able to get in the fields. I mean, it's gone. It's toast. It's withered. And we're done. So that kind of, that's the risk that I'm talking about. But enjoy the time lapse. I'm going to get this field planted. Hopefully I don't catch up to Bolt Harvest.
Yesterdays, happiness gets nearer. The light that we see closing in so fast ahead, it's hope, it's getting clearer. The more I think of all the tough times we survived, the more it makes me smile.
All right, guys, Bolt's finishing up planting. We can see him in our rearview mirror. And then I'm going to go fill everything up with fuel. And then I'm going to do maintenance on everything. Hopefully it doesn't cost too much. And then, Bolt, real quick, don't forget to plant the grass in the little spots. I was about to forget. So that we can, we're going to plant spots. Or, excuse me, we're going to plant grass in spots that we can't get with the big header. Just because we probably won't ever have another small header. Because it just wastes so much time. Like, a big header is the move. Because time is money. Like, especially when you're leasing. So we're going to put grass in spots that we aren't going to plant. All right, so I've done full maintenance on the old power stroke. Now I just need to fill up the girl. There we go. She's chugging away. All right, so $77 to fill up the power stroke. I'm curious how much it costs on, like, our other equipment, how much it actually is to fill up and stuff. Like, I'll see in, like, the 6R needs it. And then our little tractor over here needs it as well. All right, we don't run this tractor that much. This one does most of our fertilization spray. This is our spraying fertilization. Then obviously it has a front loader with forks. So that's pretty much, unless we need to like hook up something with it, I guess. All right, so that was just $42, and then I'm curious how much will it be to maintenance. I don't think it's much, but like the 6R is on its last bar for both fuel and maintenance, so like that's gonna be really expensive. All right, it's just $100, not bad. Cool. So the farm, we, Bolt and I are a tag team duo, and we knocked it all out. So we harvested, we planted, and oh, I need to also check, I guess. Actually, I don't think I'll be able to unless I, yeah, I probably won't be able to. I won't be able to check how much wheat we have because I don't have a tipper anymore. We returned it, I believe. So then I wouldn't be able to go underneath there and do that. It's not a big deal. All right, guys, that's going to wrap up the rest of today's episode. So we got everything harvested and then we got everything planted as well. So beans are in the ground. And then I looked, we had 109,000 liters. That rounds up to, so we had 109,000 liters of wheat. And then current prices are like $422 in America. That'll be about $50,000. Now, of course, if we get better prices, that could be $60,000, $70,000. So I'm going to wait for the right prices to sell that. We'll kind of keep an eye on it. So thank you guys for watching. Peace out. And I'll see y'all in the next episode.